And here I have with me my mathematics flow presentation. Math is divided into three blocks, number, algebra and measurement based on the content of the chapter. So in the number block, we have rational numbers, irrational numbers and mathematical operations with them. In the algebra block, we have polynomials, linear equations, quadratic equations and arithmetic progressions. In the measurement block, we have geometry, coordinate geometry, trigonometry, statistics and surface areas and volumes. Mathematics undoubtedly has endless applications in real life. And for that, I will be giving you an example of one application question in each block. So let's move on to the number block first. So the question we have here is, four different electronic devices make a beep after every 30 minutes, 1 hour, 1.5 hour, and 1 hour 45 minutes respectively. All the devices beep together at 12 noon. At what time will they beep again? So since the timings are given in different units, we have to first convert them into a common unit. Let's take minutes as the unit. So 30 minutes will be 30 minutes, 1 hour will be 60 minutes, 1.5 hour will be 90 minutes, and 1 hour 45 minutes will be 105 minutes. So since they beep at 12 noon now, there will be a common point at which they will beep together again. And that number will be the lowest common multiple of all the four numbers of the times given here. So when we calculate that, we get 1260 as the answer. And in order to find the number of hours after which they will beep again, we need to divide it by 60 and we'll get 21 hours as the answer. So after beeping at 12 noon on a particular day, they will beep after 21 hours, which will be at 9 a.m. on the next day. Moving on to the question in algebra. A man bought 4 horses and 9 cows for 1340 rupees. He sells the horse at a profit of 10% and the cows at a 20% gain. What price did he pay for the horse if his total gain is rupees 180? So he paid a different price for one horse and a different price for one cow. So we can take the prices as two variables, x and y, and form an equation with that. So since he bought 4 horses and 9 cows, we get 4x plus 9y is equal to the total amount that he paid, that is 1340 rupees. And then it says that he sold the horses at 10% gain and the cows at a 20% gain. So we have to add 10% of 4x to 4x to find the selling price of the horse and 20% of 9y to 9y to find the selling price of each cow. So when we form another equation with that, we also have to add 188 to 1340 because that is the overall gain that he had. So when we form an equation, we get 1528 as the answer. So now in order to find the values of x and y, first we can find the value of x in terms of y. And then later substitute that value in the second equation and further simplify. Then we get a value for y and we can substitute that value of y in this equation to find the value of x. So since x is the cost price of the horse, he paid 200 rupees for each horse that he bought. Now to verify this situation, we can represent it graphically and find out if the answer is correct. So we take the first equation, 4x plus 9y is equal to 1340, and we must simplify the second equation and we get 11x plus 27y is equal to 3820 rupees. So we find the values of x and y and then plot a graph. So this line represents the first equation and this line represents the second equation. And both the graphs meet at point C, which is 260. So the correct answer of x is 200 and therefore our answer is verified. Next, we move on to the measurement question. The barrel of a fountain pen, cylindrical in shape, is 7 cm long and 5 mm in diameter. A full barrel of ink in the pen is used up to write 330 words on an average. How many words would use up a bottle of ink containing 1/5 of a liter? So here we have a cylindrical cartridge and the dimensions are given. So first we need to find a volume of each cartridge. And when we substitute that in the formula pi r square h, we get 1.375 cm cube as the answer. So each cartridge will have 1.375 cm cube of ink. And when we convert that in terms of liter or ml, we get 1.375 ml because 1 cm cube is equal to 1 ml. Now, a person can write 330 words in 1.375 ml of ink. So in 1 ml of ink, he will be able to write 330 words divided by 1.375 ml. Now, the available amount of ink is 200 ml. And in order to find the number of words which can be written with 200 ml of ink, we need to multiply 200 with the amount of number of words that can be written in 300 in 1 ml of ink. So that will be 200 into 330 by 1.375. And when we simplify the equation, we get 48,000 words as the answer. So with the available ink, that is 200 ml of ink, we can write 48,000 of words. So if you ever wonder how much you will be able to write with a particular amount of ink that you have with you, you can use mathematics and find your answer. Here I have some important keywords and memorization points for each of the blocks, just so that you can remember and just glance it in order to have a quick revision for your mathematics. Thank you.